Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we are back. Let's play The Legend of Zelda, Wind Waker HD, and Nintendo Wii U. Last time, we went around the Great City looking for more treasure charts, and today, we've got about four more treasure charts to find, and we'll be done with that for the time being until we find more, because we're still missing a couple to actually get before we can actually go hunt the damn things down. And we might also do some more platform stuff. I think I'll look for the ones that I haven't finished off-screen, and then meet you guys at each one. Just to get them all out of the way, or we might go hunt some big octos. But anyways, we're currently at this platform, which is over near Rockspire Island, because our next treasure chest is over in Four Eye Reef. So I warped over to Great Fish Isle, and then started sailing over here, and I noticed these platforms, so I wanted to check to see if there was anything on here that I hadn't got, and I can see a treasure chest up there. And there are three platforms here, so that means there's probably going to be a treasure chest in each one, which would be really nice. So, let's see what we can do. First off, let's get rid of these chumps. Of course, I'll be kind of sad or mad or whatever if you only have a treasure chest just on this one platform here, but it seems like there should be a treasure chest in each one. You probably just got to kill each enemy. Or all the enemies or something like that. I know there was like one where you had to... I think there was like one where you had to kill all the cannons or something like that. And that got us a treasure chest, but I'm not sure if this will work. Red rupee, eh. I was hoping for something a little better. And there's a giant tornado thing over there. Okay, let's get our leaf out. And let's go ahead. Actually, no, the wind's blowing this way, so we might as well use this tornado. Actually, which way is the wind blowing? I can't tell. Well, let's get it blowing in the direction that we actually need it. Gonna have to change that at least twice. Let's see, we're facing... I can't really see. Let's try that way. Okay, close enough. Yeah, I have a map square blocking my direction, so that's close enough, I guess. I'm not seeing any enemies up there, actually. I see a few down there, but I'm not seeing too much over in this direction. Now, let's get into the tornado. There they are. Okay. Goodbye, sir. Kind of weird how I juggled that one. I don't think I've done that too much. Maybe the wind was in just the right spot for it. Item? Chest? This might be one of the ones where you have to kill the cannons on the side. Okay, anything under these barrels? Besides the fairy. And I already have full bottles, though, so I'm not really in need of that. Okay, so let's change the... Actually, you know what? While we're down here, might as well kill all these cannons if we think we might have to do it anyways. Just to get it out of the way. I hope I have enough bombs, because I actually did use a fair amount the last time we were in the boat. Alright, let's get nice and close. Yeah, we used a bunch when we were fighting that Octo. There we go, there's that. Oh, we got that guy, that works. Maybe we can get the other chump up there too. You tornado-y little fuck. Trying to get the freaking cannon to go away, but no, it wants to sit out there and just fuck me over right there. Yeah, let's try this again. And tornado, go fuck yourself, please. Okay, there's that guy, but I'm not sure if we can actually get him. Oh, what do you know? There is a treasure chest there. Cool. I don't know if that's from... killing the little moblin dude up there or what, but, well, there we go. That might be from just killing the cannon. You know what? Let's go ahead and kill the other cannons, too, just to make sure... Tornado, get the fuck off me. Because there might be, like, a treasure chest up on this one, too, that we're missing out on. There's that, and... Okay, I think I got that one. Tornado, go fuck yourself. Aiming the frickin' cannon when you're on the bow is not a very good control scheme. Because you gotta aim the cannon with the left analog stick, and then the boat turns around so slow with the right analog stick that it's ridiculous. Let's go. Kill that thing. There, jeez. Okay, so there we go. Two treasure chests. Cool. That's what I was thinking that might happen. So next time I see a platform with an empty, well, platform, I'll just try bombing it, see if that helps. Alright, get out of the boat. And I think I know what I'm going to do with all my extra rupees here. I think I'm actually just going to put on the magic armor to drain rupees with every hit I get. That way, it's actually going to something useful, keeping me alive. And that way, I can actually collect more treasure chests and stuff without being completely invincible here. I'm probably not going to need it right now, since, well, there's no enemies around except for that one guy right there. Ah! And I missed the tornado. But it looks like we should be good. Huh, I thought I killed this guy. I guess not. Alright, what do we got here? We got... a gold feather. Okay, cool. And I'm not going to use the magic armor in, like, the dungeons or anything. I just want to use it out here on the Great Sea. That way, when I'm... getting clobbered by cannons or whatever, I don't get entirely screwed over. Alright, so now we need to make the wind go that way. And try to get whatever is in that chest. Hopefully it's something good and not another... whatchamacallit, another feather or something like that. Let's see, we could use a heart piece since we have 2 out of 4 right now, that'd be nice. First, before we can use a heart piece, let's go ahead and change the wind to the proper direction here. And this is just going to be due west. Wait, I think this is actually the direction we actually had the wind blowing already. That's right, I did go to that one, not the other one. Okay, that's why that little Bokka Bloom was still there. Because I killed all the ones on that platform, and that was the guy that I missed with the... Come here. Ah. That was the guy that I missed with the ship cannon, I guess. Come on, lift me up, please. You suck. Yeah, we're gonna have to try that again. The Twister Chaser, I am not. That was a pretty good movie back in the day, back in like the... I think it came out like 94, 95, Twister, I think it had a... some reason I'm thinking Meg Ryan, but I don't think it did. It had some random blonde chick. And they were chasing tornadoes. And they made some little contraption to measure the speed of the winds. They, I think they like cut up soda cans or something like that and attached little speed measuring devices to them. I forget exactly what it was, but... yeah, I watched that like twice, and I think there was like flying cows at some point thanks to the tornado. I remember that pretty well. Vaguely. Anyways, can we get into this tornado now? Because that would be fantastic. There we go. Thank you, Cyclos. Alright, feel free to be something awesome. Hey, an orange rupee. Okay, cool. Anything else here? No? I guess not. I thought it'd be something a little better than that, but oh well. And the tornado's trying to drown me. Great. So we're getting a ton of rupees here, which is fine, I guess. But I was kind of hoping for a heart piece. That would have been really nice. I just want to make sure there's nothing else that I missed on here, like surprise whiz robe attack or anything like that. I know it's probably not, but, you know, it never hurts to check. And then we can head out to... Idiot tornadoes are really getting in the way. Okay, nothing else here. Let's just go ahead and head to... 4-star, or 4-eye reef here. Then we gotta go a little more that way there. Oh, this is the fairy island. A little further up then. I suppose we could stop at the fairies for heart replenishing, but eh. They don't replenish magic, so... Oh well, they're not really that worth it. There's those little scavenger corpses. I don't know if they ever actually find anything. I think they're just doomed to obscurity, unfortunately for them. But, oh well. Sucks for them. Let's see, Four Eye Reef should be around here somewhere. Ah, there it is. I was way on the edge of the map there for whatever reason. Alright, now is there any... Let me make sure there's nothing else awesome in this square, like an octo or anything like that, because that'd be pretty cool. No, not you, incredible chart. Octo chart. No, there's not an octo here. Okay. Platform. Nope, there's no platforms here either, so... Nothing really great going on in this square, unfortunately, except for the one whole... Actually, you know what? I'm going to get my stupid thing on here. That way, if I die somehow or get attacked by those exploding barrels... Oh, okay, good. It's on. I wasn't sure if it was actually turning on or not, but there we go. And apparently... It doesn't like the water. Huh. So it'll activate on the boat, but it won't activate in the actual water. Okay, let's see how much damage is actually... Okay, that was weird. I don't know why those just kind of stopped like that. That was really weird. Huh. Maybe it's a glitch? I don't know. It didn't take any money away either, so I'm not really sure what's going on there. Okay, there's our treasure, way in the very back. Yeah, now if this guy attacks me, he doesn't really have a say in the matter, because I'm not going to take any damage no matter what he does. Alright, there's our treasure chart right over there. Please be a piece of heart, because that'd be really nice. I don't remember if it happens in this game or not, but one of the Zelda games, I forget which one. Ooh, Great Fairy Chart. Now you can find the Great Fairies and the Fairy Queen, which is pretty useless since we already know where they are. All we already know where they all are, so oh well. But one of the Zelda games, when you collect a piece of heart, it fills up your heart meter entirely. Not just a heart container, just a piece of heart. It'll just give you a nice free refill there. And I forget if it does it in this game, because I never really paid too much attention to it. And let's see here. Our next destination is going to be Gale Island. Okay, cool. So right above Windfall Island. That's not going to cancel my... My magic charm, is it? Not that it really... Yeah, I guess it kind of helped with those exploding barrels. I mean, I somehow managed to not take any damage. course, that could have been pure luck more than anything. And actually, while we're here, I might as well grab a few bombs from the bomb shop, meaning for the fact that we are going to go after those Octos at some point, and I'd rather not be caught without them. Then again, I might just use the boomerang for the Octo since it can hit multiple eyes at once, which is a really nice, helpful little incentive to using it over the stronger arrows or the bombs. Let's see, I have 48 bombs, so I need a 50 pack. So let's go ahead and... there we go, and... there we go. And now I should be just about maxed out, if not a little less. You know what, we'll live. And do I need any arrows or anything from Beetle? I could use a few arrows, yeah, why not? But is Beetle actually sticking around? There he is. For some reason I can never find Beetle during the day on Windfall. I always have to change it to night and get him to appear at the pier right there. But I can never get him to show up during the day for whatever reason. Alright, let's go ahead and grab 30 arrows. Alright, and we're good to go. Alright, so we're going to head towards Gale Island, which is our next destination. It appears to be at the northern side of the island, which is... well, I guess it's not really nice or bad one way or the other. We'll get the damn treasure no matter what. And there it is right there. Luckily, it's a nice straight shot from Windfall, so that's really nice. And since we're just going to be right there in a minute anyways, let's see. Treasure... I'm looking at the next treasure chart here, see if I can't find that. Not really sure where this is. I'll have to actually pause and look for it because I'm not really sure. You know what? While I'm paused for a second, let me make sure there's no... anything else here that I need. Nope. Okay, nothing else nearby. And there's our treasure right there. And I'm just going to ignore this guy. Screw him. There we go. Very nice. And... hey, 100 rupees. That's kind of odd. I thought they all gave... I thought they all gave gold rupees. Huh. Oh well. Anyways, treasure chart number 43. The island looks familiar from the little picture, but I can't tell exactly where it is. Okay, it's over on Outset Island. It's just on a very... it's on the part where, it's near the part where Errol's lookout is, and they're only showing that part on the treasure chart, so it looks kind of weird, and that's why it looks familiar, but I couldn't figure out what it was exactly without actually looking at the map square for Outset Island. And after this, I don't think we have much more than one more, maybe two more charts here. Certainly not a whole lot, that's for sure. Yeah, there we go. Nice and easy, like, right next to Errol's lookout. And there we go. You know, they need a press start to skip the cutscene of opening chest button. And another orange rupee. Okay, cool. Not sure why it's skimping on the silvers, but oh well. Yeah, so we got treasure chart number 44, and apparently we've already got treasure chart number 45. So 44, that is on one of the Triangle Islands, but the question is, looks like it's Southern Triangle Island, which should be right near the Tower of the Gods. And after this, I'll go ahead and look for all those platforms off screen. I'll use the platform chart, search each one, and then if I find anything, I'll pop back in to let you guys know. That way I'm not trying to search them all on screen. Because there is a fair amount, and I'm not sure which of the ones I have or have not visited. Because honestly, they all look the same, pretty much. I mean, there's no distinguishing features on any of them, except for the fact that some have two, or some have three, so that's pretty much it. I'm hoping they give more rewards than just the joy pendants and rupees and stuff like that. Also, I'll try to find any Octos if I can. Yeah, let's see. It should be right around here somewhere. Speaking of which, I think there's an Octo around here. Oh no, it's one square to the west of here. Okay, we'll go ahead and try to find that guy too. Why not? Beetle, we're just gonna ignore you. So, see you later, buddy. Okay, that worked out pretty good. I thought I was a little far ahead of it, but I guess not. And another orange rupee. Okay, so I guess they're just skimping out on these later ones. Now, let's see, get out of here, get you out of the way, bye. And my... Okay, there we go, I was about to say, my magic shield was not on. Okay, that took about 20 rupees for that hit right there, which isn't too bad, I guess. But anyways, let's go ahead and head to the east right here and see if we can't find this Octo. I don't know which Octo we've already fought, because I know we fought one earlier in the game. I just don't know which one that is. You know what? I'm going to turn it to daytime, just for the fact that it makes my life easier trying to find these things, because I can see the seagulls a lot better in the sunshine than I can in the stormy, dark night sky. Alright. Let's see. Seagulls. We're still a little far out of the square. Okay, enough with the storm, dude. I don't want the storm. I want the not storm. Okay, there's a seagull right there. Okay, this is probably it then. Unless this is one of the ones that I've already killed. Because as far as I know, I've killed three of them. The one we killed last episode, the one for the Great Fairy upgrade, Magic Meter upgrade, and then I guess this guy. Okay, so I'm assuming this guy is done. If not, well, I'm not sure what's going on. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and go off screen now and look for all those platforms and Octos. We might actually save the Octos for later, depending on how long the platforms take per platform, because some of them might take a few minutes. Some of them might take 10 seconds, I don't know. But I'll be back in just a few minutes, or a few seconds for you, more than a few minutes for me. So, hang on. Alright, we are back in Seven Star Islands, just one square north of Dragon Roost. And while the platform there is already been taken care of, the Great Octo has not. So, I'm going to go ahead and try the boomerang here and see how well it works. Because it'll hit a fair amount here. By the way, this guy has 8 eyes for his dying pleasure. There we go, that's another couple hits there. Yeah, I think it'll take like 3 or 4 hits per eye to knock them all out. But I think it'll work out reasonably well. I don't think it'll work out so great against, like, the 12-eye Octos, because they have, well, more eyes, and I don't think you'll be able to get them all in three loops of the big thing, of the big guy here. But with the 8-eyes and the 4-eye Octos, which I think there's only one 4-eye Octo, and that was the guy that had the fairy captive. I think it'll work on those guys, but yeah, the 12 guy, probably not so much. I missed one of the eyes up there. Okay, so we're close here. Okay, that means we only have, I think we only have like the one eye left. Yeah, only got one eye left, and no, we got two eyes left. Okay, so one and two. There we go. That worked out pretty good. It was kind of a close call. I mean, we're pretty close to this guy, so I think I will stick to either the bombs or the arrows. It just takes too many hits from the boomerang. It'd be nice if it took a little less, but oh well. The boomerang is supposed to be weaker. But yeah, we already got the treasure from those platforms right there, and those were the platforms with whiz robes, so screw those guys. Should be like right around here, right? There we go. Yeah, so I'm not really too keen on fighting those guys, especially since they attack from a distance, so you can only really kill them with the bow and arrow. Hey, piece of heart, nice. I will take it. We got one more to find. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and look for some more platforms, and I'll be right back. Alrighty, we're here at the platform on Eastern Fairy Island. I didn't think the Fairy Islands actually had platforms. And I went ahead and just got this one off screen just because, well, it makes it easier that way. This one had four cannons on the bottom and then three bokoblins up top here. I don't know if we actually had to kill the cannons to get it, but I'm just going to go ahead and kill all the cannons I see on the on these from now on just to expect that I have to, pretty much. And a Bokobaba seed. Okay, cool. So there we go. And yeah, three Bokoblins and four cannons. So there we go. And I'm going to head off to the next platform. By the way, as far as I can tell, the Octos that we've got are all on the east side of the map. By the way, the guy that we just killed upstairs, or up north, apparently he had 12 eyes, not 8 eyes. I looked at the wrong one. Yeah, I guess we've killed the Octo one square north of Dragon Roost, one square south of Dragon Roost, one square southwest of Tower of the Gods, and then the one on the very bottom of the map that gives you the magic meter upgrade. So we've killed the three on the east side, the one in the very center of the map, and then we just got the two on the west side left. So there we go. But anyways, I'll go ahead and meet you guys at the next platform that I find. And yeah, like I said, I'll probably just get it all off screen at this point, and just if there's a treasure that shows up, I'll tell you what was on the platform and see how it works. If it's one of the big ones that has like three and a whole bunch of enemies, I might show that those ones, but for these little guys, nah, it's not worth it. But anyways, I'll be right back. Alright, we're at the platform on Fire Mountain, one square south of Dragon Roost Island here, and I thought I had got this one already, but I guess the cannons needed to be killed in order to get a treasure chest. So, there we go. I thought I'd got this one since it was right on the path from Dragon Roost to Forest Haven, but I guess not. Oh, and there's two treasure chests up here that I didn't get? That's odd. Huh. That's weird. I thought I would have got at least, like, the first one for, like, killing the enemies or whatever it is, but I guess not. And there we go. Golden Feather and, Yellow Rupee. Not really great, but a grand total profit of 30 rupees, minus the cost of the bombs to kill the platforms here. By the way, I'm curious if I can just get on the platform and then just place the bomb down to kill the cannons, because I've had times when I'm shooting the bombs onto the platform, and I'll end up shooting them on top of the platform, and it doesn't look like I hit the cannons, and the cannons will be destroyed anyways. So the next platform I get to that has cannons, I'm going to try that out and see if it works. Because that'd actually be reasonably effective, and probably a lot easier in my opinion than trying to aim the damn cannon. But anyways, I'll meet you guys at the next spot. By the way, this might end up being a slightly longer video, just trying to get all these platforms if I get them all. But, oh well, we'll get it out of the way, and then we'll actually get on with the plot, but I'll be right back again. Alrighty, we are back. We are at Thorned Fairy Island, which is 2 squares to the east of Tower of the Gods. And I guess my prediction about these platforms ever being on the fairy islands was way off. And by the way, the little thing that I was thinking about with the bombs hitting the cannons, if you place them just right, if you place one like right here where the cannon is, it'll hit it and it'll destroy it. So if you don't feel like manually aiming the cannons, just get up here, set your bomb down, place it with the ZR button, not the R button, and that'll put it right down where you are. Get away from it, and it'll explode the cannon beneath it. You got to be a little accurate. It's got to be reasonably above the cannon. Like, okay, the cannon's right there. You can't set the bomb right here. It's got to be closer to about right here for it to actually hit. And actually, it's probably closer to like the middle, but still, it does work. So that's really nice. And we get another golden feather for this. Okay, cool. Yeah, we've already got the treasure chest over there on that side for it. And a pretty good way to get these guys, because there was 4 Bokoblins over there, is just snipe them with the bow. It's not super accurate because you gotta account for wind distance and stuff, but with a little bit of practice, you can hit them or the pots or whatever reasonably easy. So that works out pretty nice. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and head off to the next platform here, so I'll be right back. Alright, we're here at the Bomb Island platform, which is 1 square north of the Forest Haven, and I'm beginning to think that there's a treasure chest for any platform with cannons, as long as you destroy the cannons. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys that I'm not making up the whole kill the cannons with your bomb on top of the platform thing. Because it doesn't seem like it would work, and really, there's no reason why anybody should really think it should work. But there we go. Cannon destroyed. So yeah, much easier than trying to manually aim the dang things. And I'm hoping that this will give me a treasure chest here, since all the cannons will be destroyed. Unless there's one more that I'm missing. Ah, there we go. Cannons? No? Okay, I guess this one didn't have one for the cannons. But it seems like most of the other ones do. But anyways, it might have been a waste for treasure-wise, but now we know we can actually destroy those with the bombs, and that's pretty helpful in my opinion. I mean, some other people might not find it too useful, but I think it's useful. But anyways, I'll go ahead and meet you guys at the next platform, and I'll be right back. Alrighty, we're at the Cliff Plateau Isles platform, and it is 1 square to the east of Forest Haven. And the main reason I'm showing this one is because these Wizzero bastards are here to try to screw me over. And it seems like they're doing a pretty good job of it so far. So I'm going to go ahead and get out of the boat and try to kill these guys. I might have got this one already, but if I haven't, well, it's enough incentive to kill with ropes anyways. And we don't need our bombs right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and get my shield out just for enhanced defensive purposes. Of course, you can't activate it on the ladder, that'd be too easy. Okay, that's not cool. I think this might have been one of the ones that I ran away from earlier, just for the fact that it might have been like the first time I encountered the Wiz Robes or some bullshit like that. Well, actually, let me okay, let me up the ladder, and then we can have a nice, fair fight. You sons of bastards. If I can just activate the magic shield before I got up there, that'd be great. Okay, you guys are going to try to clobber me. Okay, good. We're up here, we're safe, and apparently we've already got the platform, or the treasure here, and you can see that our rupees fall out. I don't know if we can actually... It doesn't seem like we recover them. They kind of shimmer and disappear, but there's our... There's our magic shield in action there, which is nice. Oh, got him. Alright, where you at, fella? So yeah, we kind of have our use for the rupees. Like I said, I'm not going to cheese the dungeons with it or anything like that, but it is nice for stuff like this. Okay, where are you at? Gotcha. Okay, now I'm not hoping for another treasure chest because we already got these, but I just wanted to show that one off because screw those wizrobes. And you know what? I could use that heart. Don't you disappear? And it disappeared. Okay, how about you? Do you have anything useful in you? No? Usually they have like a fairy in here or something, but I guess not today. Okay, I will go ahead and meet you guys at the next platform, so I will be right back. Alrighty, we're back. We're at the Two-Eye Reef platform, one square south of Southern Fairy Isle, I think. Yeah, Southern Fairy Island. And this one is kind of weird. It has cargo rocks, which we don't see too many of on these platforms. It has a few bokoblins, and it has these ice pots for whatever reason. There was no cannons down there, but oh well. Let's see what's in the chest first. I doubt that the ice pots are going to be anything useful, but purple rupee, not bad. But might as well break them open just to check, I guess. Can I get a twofer? I cannot. Not sure why these particular pots are frozen, but oh well. They're there, I guess. Whole lot of nothing. I'm assuming a whole lot of nothing. Whole lot of nothing. And a whole lot of nothing. Okay, so not a whole lot on this particular platform. Yeah, you get the 50 rupees, but eh, you get those just by sailing around the ocean, literally. So, anyways, I'll go ahead and meet you guys back at the next platform. I'll be right back. Alright, we are on a Diamond Step Isles, one square northwest of Outset Island, and we got ourselves another Octo here. Not sure how many eyes this guy has. I think he has like 8. Okay, yeah, he has 8. And then we have one more with 12 eyes to find. So this guy. Let's see, can I Z-target this guy with my... probably not. Yeah, let's just go ahead and... try to bow and arrow this guy to death. But again, if we can't... Oh, okay, we can target him with the... Can I? Okay, I guess we can't target him with the bow and arrow, which would have made the fight a little easier. Unless I'm missing something here. You think the bombs would have a slightly bigger area of effect so they could hit more than one eye at a time, but oh well. Go. Yeah, bombs are definitely the way to go. I mean, maybe a little bit of a pain in the butt to aim, but they're going to do way more damage than either of the others, because the bow and arrow, it still takes 2 to kill the dang thing. Or kill each eye, I guess. So yeah, let's just stick with the bombs then. And feel free to give me something awesome, because that'd be great. Like another magic upgrade, that'd be fantastic. Unfortunately, that's not going to happen, but it would be nice. Right. There we go. Alright, feel free to be something awesome. Like, not rupees. You know, in real life, or my wallet doesn't have a limit, I'd be happy to find money in the ocean all day long. Here, eh, not so much. Okay, there is a platform... north of Windfall, but I'm not sure if we got it. So again, I'll just go ahead and meet you guys there. If there's something there. If not, I'll be... Alrighty, we're here at the Islet of Steel, and it had a platform on it. And on that platform was two Bokoblins, and when you kill those two little turds, two Wizrobes appear. When you kill them, the treasure chest appears. So there we go. For Wizrobes, I hope it's something worthwhile. And a skull necklace. Oh well. And let's see, there's only a few more left that I actually have to check here. Let's see, there is... And I think there's only one more Octo, actually. So yeah, there's one more Octo, and that bad boy is hiding out at Tingle's house. I always knew that creepy little bastard was hiding something. And then as for the platforms, there are... That I have to check, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more that I have to check. But I'm pretty sure I've gotten at least 2 or 3 of those. So, I'll meet you guys in the next one. Alrighty, we're here at Stonewatcher Island, which is exactly 1 square southeast of Greatfish Isle. By the way, Islet of Steel, in case you forgot, 1 square south of Greatfish Isle. And this bad boy on Stonewatcher Island is packed with freaking cannons right here. This is a lot of cannons, so let's just try to kill a couple of them before we get up there. And then we'll just stealth bomb the rest, I guess. Unless these might be easy to get like this, I don't know. Yeah, that's 4 that I've killed already, and I'm thinking another 4 on this side. That is a lot of cannons right there. This better be hiding something nice. Then again, probably like a joy pendant or some bullshit. You know, who knows, it might even be 2 joy pendants. Okay, you can stop firing on me now, that'd be great. But obviously you're doing your job well enough if you're hitting me like that. Okay, there we go, got it. I could have my invincibility... Heroes charm thingy on, but you know what? We'll live. I guess I had to take a little bit of damage here. Besides, I'm not completely maxed out of rupees at the moment. Alright, you're the last one. Oh, I guess you are. Hey, and it's one of the spiky treasure chests. That means there's probably something good. Maybe it'll be another treasure chart. That'd be nice. Or a heart piece. Or, knowing the bastards, it might just be like 200 rupees instead of the joy pendant. I don't know. Hopefully something tolerable. See, the next platform after this is a square north of here, and then there's one a square east of there, and there's also one a square north and a square northeast of that. So, there's only a few more left. Oh, and I guess we killed these guys and got the... original treasure chest for these guys, but not the actual good treasure chest, which is this one. Oops. Hey, a heart piece, nice. Ooh, and it fills up our heart containers. Nice. I'll take it. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and check on the next couple platforms, and I'll see you guys in just a minute. Alrighty, we're here at a Six Eye Reef. We're destroying all the cannons on the platform. Gets you a treasure chest up here. And in case you forget, Six Eye Reef is exactly 1 square to the west of the Tower of the Gods. And we get a skull necklace for our troubles. I guess that's okay. Alright, I'll meet you guys in the next one. And I'll probably save Tingle, the Octo at Tingle's for last. That way I can go stock up on bombs before I go fight the dang thing. Alright, we're here at Star Island, 1 square to the east of Forsaken Fortress. And this treasure chest was just out here with a few Bokoblins. And it's a golden feather. Okay, great. So you are done, sir. There was a few cannons down below, but they didn't give me anything. So, oh well. And you know what? I have, I think, enough bombs, so I'm just going to go ahead and try to take on this Octorok without getting any extras. If it comes down to it, I'll just boomerang it to death or something like that. So, Tingle Island, here we go. And you know what? I don't think we actually ever talked to the other Tingle brothers. I think we talked to Tingle. I don't think we talked to his little friends, I guess. So, let's do that real fast and then go for the Octo, and then we'll be done. Plus, we can check out those creepy Tingle statues. I'm not going to bother reading the dialogue for these guys, because, well, that'll just taint my soul, and We don't need any of that. Alright, if you guys want to give me some bombs while I'm here, that'd be great. Or don't give me anything at all, okay. Let's see, do these say anything, or are they just here to be creepy? I guess you can pick them up, which is cool, I guess. If we, like, throw them away. Let's see what happens if we throw it in the ocean. I hope we don't have to go back to the dungeon and get it. I would assume not, but that'd be kind of a dastardly... Okay, I just kind of put it down there. Alright, now... There we go. Goodbye. And then, can we attack these things? We cannot. Oh, there's a... Did I already get this? I probably did. Yeah, I did. Okay, so enough putzing around with the Tingle statues. Let's just go talk to the Tingle brothers and then get out of here. It's kind of weird that you can pick them up, but oh well. And I think Tingle does actually pay you for these statues. I think it gives you like 100 rupees or something per statue. Heave, ho, ugh, this is heavy. This is just between you and me. This guy is another brother. If that guy could come spin this thing instead of me... Heave, ho... Okay. I think this actually might be... Oh, it's so heavy. Isn't there anyone who could spin this thing for me? One of these guys is actually not related to Tingle at all. It's just some guy that washed up on the island, and Tingle put him to work. Thank you for the gift. I know that Tingle statues are quite hard to come by. It's not much, but please... Take this. Got a reward for being so skillful at finding Tingle statues. 50 rupees? Nice. Oh, per statue. I know what my big brother is like, but please play with him again soon. Otherwise, he gets out of sorts. Okay, so that probably gave us the 400 or 200 rupees, I guess. I mean, it is quite amusing. A Tingle bottle, I mean. But no, really. I would not expect you to... You know, I wish they had implemented the Tingle Tuner from the GameCube version of the game, because we have the frickin' screen on the Wii U gamepad, but oh well. Oh, Mr. Fairy, I've been longing to see you, sir. What should we play? What do you want to play? What? You're not here to play. Goodbye, Mr. Fairy. Please come visit me here at Tingle Tower again, where wonderful fairy magic makes the place spin and spin. You know, besides your... brother and the guy that washed up on the shore and you forced to put him in an outfit. It's kind of sad the guy that washed up on shore happens to look exactly like Tingle somehow, but oh well. Okay, Tingle does not want to play, so we're just going to go ahead and get out of here and let these guys creep along all by their lonesomes. You know, they could set up like a gear system or something that would, you know, take care of the Tingle statue for him, but I guess that just wouldn't be any fun, would it? Okay, now, the last Octo is in the square somewhere. I'm just not sure where. Ah, that must be them right there. But then again, that's only a few seagulls. I hope. Okay, good. It is these guys. Alright. So, let's go ahead and get this guy. He's sitting pretty on 12 eyes. Okay, so if I can just... get my aim down, that'd be great. Unfortunately, my aim is not always great. There we go, doing pretty good so far. Kind of twitching when I hit him, so that makes it a little more of a challenge to actually hit his eyeballs, but I think we'll manage. It's kind of weird how the rest of his body is impervious to bombs and arrows, and it's just his eyeballs. I mean, I'm pretty sure if I got hit by a cannonball anywhere in my body, it would hurt, but I guess this guy's just super Octo or something. Get that eyeball. And the tentacle got in the way. Damn, tentacle porn. Alright, I think we only got like one more here. Actually, let's see what we got. Two more. Okay, so let's see. Oh, we got three more. Okay, get you. Get you, and... that guy's way over there. Come on, we only have a few more here. You know what? Can't lose this. I don't want to lose this. We're very close to not making this here. As far as I can tell. Yeah, we're very close to... Okay, one more shot here. And that should get him, I hope. Got him. Okay, oof. That guy was kind of tough. Mainly because I was trying to conserve my bombs, but still, reasonably challenging. Alright, now feel free to have something good. That'd be great. Probably more rupees. But, you know what? Who cares? Take what you can get. I wonder if these treasure chests that we find on the bottom of the sea are from old Hyrule, like, you know, before it was flooded. Hey, a piece of heart. Cool. Hey, that means that... Okay, I need 3 more pieces of heart for another heart container. And then we're going to get the heart container from the boss. So, I guess the boss right there, that's going to be the last heart container for the game that we get. Besides the heart pieces ones. So, I thought there was like another place that we got another heart out of it, but I guess not. So, cool. But yeah, I wonder if the treasures that we pull up with a grappling hook are actually from like old Hyrule before it was flooded. And, you know, it's just some random treasure chest from a dungeon or something that has the ceiling cracked open or something like that. Oh well. But anyways, we managed to take care of a fair amount of stuff. This is probably going to end up being a long episode. So we got all the platforms taken care of. We got all the Octoroks taken care of. Submarines, those were taken care of a while ago. Light rings. I looked that up as best as I could. And as far as I can tell, it's just like any other light ring. And it gives you 50 rupees. And they respawn during the full moon. So, good for those, I guess. Secret caves, well, we've been finding those all over the place anyway, so I'm not too terribly worried about that. Sea hearts, I'm pretty sure we've got most of them by now. Island hearts, again, I'm pretty sure we've got most of them since we only have 3 left to find. Great fairies, we found all those. Octos, incredible, and tingle. Okay, so we've pretty much cleared out all of our treasure charts. Put all of our special treasure charts to use. And we still got a few more treasure charts to find, I think like maybe 5 or 6. And then, actually, at least 10, because I'm missing 45 through 55. So that's kind of a fair amount that I'm missing, actually. It's just kind of weird. I'm kind of nervous now. But next episode, we're actually going to go ahead and find my car and get our way to the Wind Temple. So, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good night.